Hey, how you doing? It's Mark from JC Video. I wanted to take a minute and talk a little bit about our latest and greatest product called GoPro. GoPro is not our product, but we did make some compatibility so that you can connect your GoPro to your JC Video software and communicate wirelessly without any cords. No more FireWire. If you guys have had FireWire for years, you will not miss going without the FireWire. So how it works is the GoPro actually creates its own little wireless signal. So if you don't have internet on the range, you don't need to worry. You do not need internet to have the wireless capability from the GoPro communicate with your computer. The GoPro acts like its own little Wi-Fi spot. Just like you're connecting to your Wi-Fi at your hotel, start your computer, search for networks, connect to your GoPro, and then you can control and communicate with your GoPro wirelessly. All right, so let me just kind of show you how it works there. Right now, what you're seeing on the screen over here is, well, was live streaming, and there's nobody in front of it now, but the live streaming will come about 3 seconds, there's about a 3 second delay. So all that is intended for is for you to be able to frame your student. Now, when your battery starts getting low, your 3 second delay in the Wi-Fi or the wireless preview mode actually just turns into a snapshot. So if your battery's low, at least you can get a snapshot before you record so you can see how your camera's framed. So your camera only needs to be about 2 feet, maybe 3 feet from the ball at the most. It's got a super wide angle lens, which is one of the things I'm not too crazy about, but there is a setting on the camera that will allow you to negate that super wide fish angle effect just a little bit, but it is there if you do need it. Really like the camera, super high resolution, 100 frames a second, up to 120 frames a second, at a really good resolution, up to 240 frames a second even. So those make for a nice, good, smooth, super slow motion. And it's really easy to use, relatively inexpensive, and available, and wireless. All right, so if I'm going to capture a swing with my student, I would be back at my control panel at the computer. I would ask my student, go ahead, take your address. Let's go ahead and hit one. Okay, I wait for the beep. Okay, and I hit it. Okay. We've got a program so that the camera will start, record for 3 seconds, and then automatically stop. After that, the computer's gonna talk to the camera. Let's go ahead and pan over here. And it's gonna automatically import that video right into the program. Now, as you can see right here, we got a nice clean video. If you notice during the preview, the video wasn't so good because in the preview, they're taking a little tiny image and we're stretching it out. And when you take a little tiny image and stretch it out, it makes for a very poor image. However, now that we've captured, what you see here is a nice high quality image. Now we are inside so that I can show you and demonstrate how this works, but I've had a lot of questions on, will this GoPro work inside? And the answer is no. Well, it works, and let's show you what happens. Go ahead and scrub this back and let's get it halfway down on the backswing. Okay. And as you can see, you get motion blur. When that shaft blurs, that's called motion blur, and that's a result of not a high enough shutter speed, okay? So when there's not a high enough shutter speed, the shutter's open too long, the club moves too much inside that frame, and you get motion blur. So you can see the body positions. I mean, you know, you could actually use this. Just go ahead and frame advance through that. You could actually use this, but you can see I don't see any club. I don't see any shaft. I mean, I guess in a pinch it would do. Makes it really convenient, but it is mostly suited for outside. Let's go ahead, while we're right here, let's go ahead and pull up a clip so you can see what it looks like outside. Okay, now this frame right there, let's go back to that frame. You can see a really nice clean image. I shot this at an angle so you could see what we call a rolling shutter. Now, the higher the shutter speed on the camera, the better the lighting on the subject, the less rolling shutter effect that you see. Now that's one of my big kind of, you know, pet peeves is I really don't like to see that club bowing forward, but for what you're investing in the camera, you get very little club bow or rolling shutter effect through impact, provided there's enough light. All right, now let's go to one that's where there's not quite so much light. Yeah, it's one over, oh, perfect, okay. And you'll see that there's a little bit more, okay, of the rolling shutter, okay? So as you see, it starts to happen just a little bit right here. And go one more frame. And you see quite a little bit. Now that's kind of just an optical illusion, and that's how the camera takes the picture. Now, down the line, you don't see that. So it's kind of a relative down the line. So let's go ahead and take a down the line shot. Okay, and let's just go ahead and back that up. Okay. And from the top down, you see a nice clean picture. And this is actually even a little bit later in the evening at our power line range here. But you can see the ball going off into the distance. Go ahead and let that roll forward. And if you needed to, you could zoom way in. Actually, let's go ahead and show you. Because the pictures are high resolution, the zoom capability is fantastic. So you can see it looks like I'm a million miles away. But watch this. I'm going to zoom in on this area. Okay. Now, just scrub that back and forth, and you can see really, really a nice, clean, good picture. So, things I like about the camera, it's inexpensive, it's wireless, high quality image, high frame rate. Things I don't like about the camera, the wide angle lens, but there is a setting to negate that. And the battery's not so, you know, the battery life is not so good with the wireless on. However, if you get a little solar pack that you use for hiking, Costco has them, the bigger the solar pack, the more energy. I think you could probably run all day using the GoPro battery with that solar pack and not have to worry about battery. Now, they also offer an extended battery with GoPro. So you can, you know, you can double the battery life, which should give you 4 hours record time. And with a solar panel, it should be all you need. Now, what we do to save battery is if you're not filming, we actually have a tool that shuts the camera off after 60 seconds. So if you're not capturing, you just turn the camera back on wireless. It doesn't shut the wireless off, so you can still go back in and turn the camera on. It just powers the camera down to save battery. So there's good things, there's bad things, but I wanted to give you just a little demonstration of how easy it is to use, and I'm just gonna hit one more just to show you the process all over again. Okay, and there's my preview. Okay, I'm gonna tell my student, okay, go ahead and hit it. Student waits for the beep. Hopefully pipes it right down the middle. 5 seconds later, that picture appears on the screen and you can go ahead and start your analyzing. And here we come. Beautiful. And there's the latest video we just shot. Wireless, its own Wi-Fi network. You don't need the internet. Call us with questions. I hope you enjoyed this video.